In today's highly virtual world, people are searching for creative ways to feel more connected and immersed, more together on video calls. And I say it's time to take our presentations and our slides into the 3D space and into virtual world platforms such as this one called FrameVR, where you can customize the space to how you want to be, move around in it freely, add different photos, videos, PDFs, and 3D models to go with your presentation or experience. You can even share your camera or screen and meet your colleagues, friends, clients, and students in here as well. And with the same ease that you'd flip through your PowerPoint slides, which you can do here too, you can change the entire surroundings with the snap of a finger and change all of the objects and images in your entire environment. I can change, for example, the windows here, the view in the windows. These are 360 photos, by the way. And this one I took at a friend's house myself. And you can also change all of the images, videos, and 3D models that you're showing. This custom one, by the way, I made myself by customizing one of Microsoft's 3D models in Paint 3D. Check out my tutorial from a while back for how to do that in the description. And the process today is actually still quite similar. These platforms are kind of like Second Life or The Sims in that you have avatars that move around in a 3D space and can watch and interact with a presentation, do smaller breakout rooms, or just have people go in by themselves and explore the space. Now, there are a ton of these platforms out there right now, as shown in Charlie Fink's XR directory, which he keeps constantly up to date. And the one I'm using today, as I mentioned, is called FrameVR by Verbella Labs, which doesn't require any download as it's fully web-based. As of right now, it's in beta and you can sign up and try it out for free. And I promise this is not a sponsored video. I just really like this platform for immersive meetings and presentations. And this also isn't meant to be a comprehensive tutorial, but really give you a taster of what a platform like this looks like so you can explore for yourself. The FrameVR team actually has a lot of tutorials on their own channel that you can use to get kind of the details on how to do things. But I will show you how to get started. So the first step is to go to framevr.io and sign up with your email and password. And you can get started immediately, nothing at all to download. And it works on most desktops, mobile devices, and virtual reality headsets as well. Once you've created an account, you can go to create new frame and make that first frame for yourself. And the frame is kind of the environment that you're in. And you'll also have a unique URL for the space that you can invite people to. So after you do all that, you can get started with building your frame. You first choose which environment you want to use, the template, which is really important. Here are the environments that they currently have, and I'm sure they'll be adding many more in the future too. They have everything from small kind of art galleries or conference spaces to large expo halls as well. And then you can also customize the permissions for each frame. So you can give it to anybody who has the URL, or you can invite certain accounts into the space as well. And then the fun part, of course, is customizing your frame to fit your needs. So to do that, go to add to this frame, and then you can pull in a variety of images, photo spheres, or 360 images, videos, PDFs, and 3D models. And you can go ahead and add them in through this menu. Once you do that, make sure that you are in edit mode so you can kind of customize them and move the objects around. So in order to move an object, you just click it with the mouse and then you use your arrow keys to kind of move it around to where you want it to go. And then you can also resize it as you like. And then same process with any kind of image or PDF or anything that you can add in here. And then what's neat is you can put the different objects and items into the different scenes, which works sort of like 3D PowerPoint slides. You can change the look of your whole environment, which includes the sky and any images or objects that you have imported. PDFs, by the way, are clickable, so you can actually scroll through them. And the audience can do that on their own or as part of a presentation by you. And everything that you've built will be saved here for when you come back and will be visible to anybody that you invite into this space. Just give them the URL to the space and they can join. Super easy, nothing to download, which I know can be a barrier with IT if you have a work computer. The other thing that's neat is you can share your screen or your camera, either on the screen here on the wall or on top of your avatar, which of course massively adds to the immersion and kind of the human connection that you can have in this platform. If you are running a networking event or you want to try something new with your team or audience that's more immersive and innovative than video conferencing, then FrameVR is a really great place to start experimenting. Well, thanks so much for watching. Hopefully this was a useful overview of what the future of presentations could look like and how to start experimenting with making your meetings more immersive. Please comment, like, and subscribe if you enjoyed the video, and see you soon for my next one.